101st Regiment Royal Artillery. The Geordie and West Riding Gunners are the Royal Artillery's Army Reserve unit in the northeast of England, and the only Army Reserve unit to hold, maintain and train on the armored tracked M270, Multiple Launch Rocket System, MLRS. The MLRS is the British Army's main precision fire weapon system, able to engage targets at long ranges with extreme accuracy. Each battery has its own reconnaissance and command sections which control the MLRS movement and firing, as well as the delivery of ammunition. The three-man MLRS detachment will often operate and move independently, as will the other elements of the battery, such as the two-man ammunition crew. Under the Army 2020 restructuring project, the regiment re-rolled to become a depth fires regiment equipped with the fearsome MLRS. It is now paired with its regular Army counterpart, 26 Regiment RA, and trains hard to meet the next challenge, supporting both UK and NATO formations. Guided Multiple Launch Rocket System, GMLRS. The state-of-the-art M270B1 Multiple Launch Rocket System, firing the M31 Guided Multiple Launch Rocket System, GMLRS, munition, is the mainstay of the British Army's deep and shaping fires capability. The system provides pinpoint accuracy, delivering a 200-pound high explosive warhead to its target with over twice the range of other artillery systems used by the British Army. The MLRS also represents the bulk of the Army's precision fires capability, with the GPS guidance capability integral to the system, and highly accurate beyond 70 km. The weapon system is manned by a small crew of three gunners and is mounted on a tracked armored launcher, which is highly robust and maneuverable. Rockets, 12 rounds 40 seconds, missiles, 2 rounds 10 seconds. The GMLRS fires surface-to-surface rockets and the Army Tactical Missile System, ATACMS. Without leaving the cab, the crew of three, driver, gunner and section chief, can fire up to 12 rockets in less than 60 seconds. The GMLRS launcher unit is loaded with 12 rockets, packaged in 2 6 rocket pods. The launcher, which is mounted on a stretched Bradley chassis, is a highly automated self-loading and self-aiming system. It contains a fire control computer that integrates the vehicle in rocket launching operations. The rockets can be fired individually or in ripples of 2 to 12. Accuracy is maintained in all firing modes because the computer re-aims the launcher between rounds. The M270 MLRS can be readily transported to the area of operations, for example, by the C-5 transporter aircraft or by train. MLRS offers optimal cross-country mobility and a road speed of 64 km per hour. The combat-proven Multiple Launch Rocket System, MLRS-270, is a rocket artillery system manufactured by Lockheed Martin Missiles and Fire Control. The system is operational in the US Army, while Bahrain, Denmark, France, Germany, Greece, Israel, Italy, Japan, South Korea, the Netherlands, Norway, Turkey and the UK have fielded or ordered MLRS. The system has also been built in Europe by an international consortium of companies from France, Germany, Italy and the UK. Multiple Launch Rocket System Tactical Rocket Warhead and Munitions. The basic MLRS Tactical Rocket Warhead contains 644 M77 munitions, which are dispensed above the target in mid-air. The dual-purpose bomblets are armed during freefall, and a simple drag ribbon orients the bomblets for impact. Each MLRS launcher can deliver almost 8,000 munitions in fewer than 60 seconds at ranges exceeding 32 kilometers. Other mission-oriented rockets include the Extended Range, ER, rocket, the Reduced Range Practice Rocket, RRPR, with a range of 8 km to 15 km, and the AT-2, which dispenses 28 anti-tank mines around. The Extended Range Rocket was first fielded in 1998 and carries 518 improved munitions in excess of 45 km. M270 MLRS Fire Control. The MLRS computerized fire control system enables a reduced crew, or even a single soldier, to load and unload the launcher. A portable boom control device and cable hook assembly is used for loading and unloading. The fire control computer allows firing missions to be carried out either manually or automatically. In a typical fire mission, a command post transmits the selected target data directly to the MLRS computer. The computer aims the launcher and prompts the crew to arm and fire a pre-selected number of rounds. Multiple mission sequences can be pre-programmed and stored in the computer. ATACMS, Army Tactical Missile System. MLRS also fires the long-range Lockheed Martin Army Tactical Missile System, ATACMS, guided missiles. The ATACMS family includes the Block 1, Block 1A and Block 1A unitary missiles. Block 1, which was used during Operation Desert Storm, carries 950 baseball-sized M-74 submunitions to ranges exceeding 165 kilometers. The Block Iowa missile extends the range to more than 300 kilometers by reducing the submunition payload and adding GPS guidance. The Block 1A unitary missile, with a single burst warhead, was first deployed in support of Operation Iraqi Freedom in March-April 2003. Lockheed Martin was awarded a first U.S. Army contract for the production of the unitary missile in February 2004 and a second, for 50 missiles, in January 2005. Guided Multiple Launch Rocket System, GMLRS. Lockheed Martin developed a new extended-range guided MLRS, GMLRS, which has a range of more than 70 kilometers. The GMLRS XM-30 rocket has a GPS, global positioning system, an inertial guidance package and small canards on the rocket nose to enhance accuracy. GMLRS completed system development and demonstration, SDD, tests in December 2002, and entered low-rate initial production in April 2003. A total of 156 GMLRS rockets were produced under the LRIPI contract, deliveries completed May 2005, 840 under the LRIP2, awarded in March 2004, and 1014 under LRIP3, awarded February 2005. IOC was achieved in 2006, but the system has been operationally deployed since September 2005 in Iraq. The GMLRS is an international program involving the UK, Italy, France, and Germany, as well as the US. The industrial team includes Diehl, MBDA and Fiat Avio. GMLRS orders and deliveries. In August 2005, the UK placed a contract for GMLRS, becoming the first international customer. GMLRS entered service with the UK Army Royal Artillery in April 2007, and began deployment to Afghanistan in June 2007. First deliveries of a unitary variant of GMLRS, with a single 81.6 kilograms, 180 pounds, warhead and a range of up to 70 kilometers, were made in May 2005. In October 2003, Lockheed Martin was awarded an SDD contract for 86 unitary variant rockets, delivered in June 2005. The program was accelerated following a U.S. Army urgent need statement in January 2005, and the first 72 GMLRS unitary rockets were delivered in June of that year. Lockheed Martin conducted 17 tests on the unitary variant in 2006. In June 2007, GMLRS unitary entered low-rate initial production, LRIP. Operational testing was completed in April 2008. A follow-on contract was awarded in August 2008. M270A1, upgraded MLRS launcher. In December 2000, a low-rate initial production contract was placed with Lockheed Martin for 66 upgraded M270A1 launchers for delivery by 2004. MLRS launchers upgraded to M270AI status have improved fire control systems, IFCS, and improved launcher mechanical systems, ILMS. The M270A1 launcher completed operational testing in October 2001 and was first fielded in May 2002. Lockheed Martin also received a FMS, Foreign Military Sales, contract for the new launchers from the Republic of Korea. The IFCS provides additional capacity to accommodate complex munitions and modern computer electronics, including video display, onboard navigation with global positioning system, architecture for ultra-fast signal processing, and advanced mission software. ILMS reduces the time to aim the launcher to 16 seconds, compared to 93 seconds. The reloading time is cut from 4 to 3 minutes. UK systems also received the IFCS. The first 15 systems for the UK were ordered in March 2005 for delivery by the end of 2006. Italian, German and French MLRS systems feature the European Fire Control Systems, EFCS, developed by Yves Dornier.